Good evening to everyone.
Very good
It
afternoon,
is
ma'am.
my pleasure. Yeah, sir. Good afternoon, sir. It is my pleasure to welcome you all for today's webinar. I would like to thank you for joining us today. Idaya Engineering College for Women, Chinnasalem, always impart qualitative intellectual knowledge and skill-based professional education exclusively for women through the competent staff. As today, with the blessings of God Almighty, Internal Quality Assurance Cell of IECW organizes the webinar on Research Initiatives and IPR Practices. I hope this webinar will give you a broader understanding of research and IPR. I strongly hope that the participants gathered for this webinar today will offer their generous support and cooperation for the successful completion. My best wishes to all of you. Take out maximum learning from this session. Before we start the session, few instructions to all the participants. Kindly mute your audio and video and try to avoid using present mode when entering the session. Request you to ask your queries in the chat window. If you join through YouTube link, kindly mention your name, destination, institution name, email ID for the attendance purpose, and you may post the questions in the chat window. The feedback link will be sent in the chat window at the end of the session. After completing the feedback form successfully, e-certificate will be issued to your register mail ID in a week. Remember that if you are not able to hear or see the participants of the meeting properly, then not necessarily it's because of others' poor network bandwidth. It can be yours. So check your network and your system. We have been trying our best to make the webinar a grand event. Your cooperation is always necessary. Now, let us start this session by invoking the God's presence and blessings. Dear God, thank you for all the blessings you have bestowed upon us. We are truly grateful for them. Thank you for allowing us today to meet and share our knowledge and time with one another in this webinar. We humbly ask you to share our speaker today of your greatest inspiration so that he may share the most of his knowledge, heart and soul to his respective topics. May he be blessed as he continues to bring his expertise to all the participants of today's program. We pray that you bless all the committees in charge that they may be able to fulfill their task responsibly, that the objectives they have set may all be achieved. Your infinite blessing would mean the success of this webinar. Bless the participants as well so that they would be able to collect the vital information from this program. May we also absorb the invaluable knowledge experiences and put it into practice what we may learn today. For all this, we ask your grace and guidance. Amen. Now, I invite Engineer Jaya Lydia Jennifer, Assistant Professor of Tribble Department, to deliver the welcome address.
Good evening and welcome everyone. It's my immense pleasure to welcome you all for this webinar. Research is to see what everybody else has seen and to think what nobody else has thought. Intellectual property is a key aspect for economic development. For gaining knowledge about research methods and intellectual property, Internal Quality Assurance Cell of Idaya Engineering College for Women organized a webinar on Research Initiatives and IPR Practices. I'm happy to welcome Reverend Mother John Brito Mary, Secretary of IECW, who is an inevitable personality, and it is a real fact that under her strong leadership, we have done our best. On behalf of the Hidaya Engineering College for Women, I welcome Professor Ramesh Chandra Panda, Dean, Research and Development Cell, Synergy Institute of Engineering and Technology, Odisha. He is a man of determination, always ready to share his knowledge and experience about research methodology with us. He is a well-wisher of our institution, who is ready to collaborate with us for the betterment of our college. I am immensely pleased to welcome you, sir. I express my warm welcome to Dr. R. Gurumani, Principal of IECW, who is a man of orderliness. Sir, your support and guidance plays a vital part in making this event successfully. I am delighted to welcome our Vice Principal, Dr. Sister A. Jinita, Convener of IQAC, who is great ambitious person in every step of IDEA activities and the main brain behind this event. I wholeheartedly welcome the members of Internal Quality Assurance Cell who rendered the ceaseless time to make this event a great one. I'm glad to welcome all the heads of the departments, fellow faculty members of the IECW to this webinar. I'm much delighted to welcome all the professors who joined from other institutions, undergraduate and postgraduate students of various institutions with immense base. We greet you all for your overwhelming response towards this event. Hope you make use of this webinar well. I wish the webinar to become a great success. Once again, I welcome you all. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Now I invite Dr. R. Gurumani, Principal of IECW, to give the felicitation address.
I am Dr. Gurumani, Reverend Secretary of Hidaya Engineering College. Reverend Secretary of Hidaya Engineering College for Women, Chinnasailam, Tamil Nadu. Respected Sister Jinita, Vice Principal and IQAC Coordinator of Hidaya Engineering College for Women. Respected Professor Ramesh Chandra Panda, Dean R&D Cell, Synergy Institute of Engineering and Technology, Odisha. Respected HODs, Organizing Committee and IQAC members, teaching fraternities from various institutions, faculty members of the IECW, UG students, PG students, and research scholars of various institutions. Good evening to all. Today's webinar is titled as Research Initiative and IPR Practices. It is an art program conducted at appropriate time because higher level approving bodies of higher education institution and affiliating universities are persuading the institutions to get accreditation status. In accreditation status, as well as that in the norms, considerable weightage is given to research, innovation, and extension activities. And also, they have given guidelines for doing quality research and devised a coursework on research publication ethics. Usually, research will lead to acquiring PhD degree and ultimately lead to patent registration if it is a breakthrough research, in addition to the quality publications. Patent filing creates a confidence and also a self-checking mechanism. It is giving a way to check their findings, which are free from repetition, cosmetic, and plagiarized. So, equal importance are to be given for research publication and patent filing, and both of these to be considered as an integral part of the research. I hope that today's program will give you a perspective towards this direction. I request you all to make use of this program. I wish this program a great success. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir. Now, I request Engineer Sister Catherine Mary, Assistant Professor of ECE, to give introduction about the chief guest.
A pleasant evening to everyone. I, Sister Catherine, Assistant Professor of ECE Department, would like to introduce today's research person, Professor Ramesh Chandra Panta, Dean, Research and Development Cell, Synergy Institute of Engineering and Technology, Odisha. He is a professional with a distinguished career of over 14 years of industrial and academic experience, providing educational instruction, engineering projects, and training solutions to individuals. He is also a research guide, editor, and reviewer of 6 international UGC CareListed and Scopus Intext journals. He is an accomplished writer with 12 textbooks to his credit, namely Industrial People Management, Joy of Engineering and Management, Interdisciplinary Pricing Gap Between Education and Industry Requirements. Professor Panda published and accepted 28 research papers and published 178 research patents, research copyright under Intellectual Property of India and Intext at WIPO, Switzerland. To establish himself in the field of education, to utilize his skills and experience to help students to achieve high improvements in career, he is also granted 22 Australian patents and filed more than 27 Australian innovation patents. He is a man of self-directed, enthusiastic educator with a passionate commitment to institute development and the learning experience. In specific, he is known for his special skill in design of challenging, enriching, and innovative activities that address the diverse interests and need of students. He has been serving in a growth-oriented organization where sincerity and hard work pay. We are privileged to have an opportunity to listen to the great personality, Professor Ramesh Chandra Panta, this evening. On behalf of all gathered here in this virtual meet, I welcome you, sir, to take up the session. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much. Please share my PPT. Okay, thank you. Right. It was really lovely when you started, you know, something with taking the oath of God. Madam, I don't know her name exactly. Before starting any work, you know, any positive work in our life, we take the blessings of God. I really appreciate the effort made by Adya College of Engineering for Women for this webinar, Resource Initiative and IPR Practices. Thank you very much for giving this opportunities. At the same time, I like to convey my gratitude to the management of college, chairman sir, principal of college, vice principal madam, all the deans of departments, head of the department, faculties, all participants, and my beloved students. Thank you very much for listening to me. So before starting this webinar, I have, you know, few things to forecast actually. Number one, never take these difficulties as this COVID difficulties, as a barriers. Always take it as a positive. Because you are, as a part of a higher educations, we are getting plenty of time together to learn and grow. to invest ourselves into research, into incubation houses, into startups, to make our wards and students learn about new technology integrations, right? So take it as an opportunity that you are getting 1.5 years time, then and try to invest this time properly. This is the positive life attitude towards life. Number two, being a faculty, I always take the responsibility, my student, my responsibility. Suppose I'm a faculty of, you know, mechanical department or electronics department, it is my responsibility always how to motivate, how to groom my student during this pandemic time. How I'll connect with my students in social medias, conducting webinars, conducting various online classes, it's my responsibility. And for students, those are participating this webinar, as your teachers are putting effort best for your career uplift, they are the next to God, the next to God in your life. So always do care, respect, take their blessings always, because blessings is the biggest, you know, without blessing, you can't achieve anything in your life. Blessing is the biggest part of life. So your parental blessings, elderly blessings, your teacher's guidance, your mentor's guidance, always take you in the right path of your life. Thank you. So this topic, innovation, incubation, startups, and research initiative and challenges here in India, this is the topic of the day. As already ma'am told that we already granted more than 45 to 50 number of Indian resource copyright and Indian patents, utility patent, Indian industrial design patents, Australian innovations patent. I always put my effort best into learn and implement new technologies into social difficulty type of problem statements. Being a part of higher education, being a part of intellectual society, we all are, you know, we are doing engineering, right? We all are part of higher education. What's supposed to be our objective? Our objective supposed to help our society to understand the problem statement, societal barriers, challenges, and how we together, because individually you can't achieve great, how we together bring such kind of innovations or product development, because innovation is the highest form of research. When you will reach yourself into all sort of, you know, technologies, all sort of book practices, theorems you are learning from textbook, fundamentals, hands-on learning you are doing in classroom activity or laboratories, then only you can, you know, think of innovations. And before going to any innovation, first of all, you prepare the list of challenges, societal barriers, societal difficulties. And when you are getting any kind of solutions, write to your nearby authorities. Intimate or inform to your collector, intimate or inform to your video blog development officer, any kind of societal, you know, development oriented, you know, thinking process or ideation, even being a part of, you know, higher education, it is also our responsibility. And second, how we come together, develop the economic standard of our nation. These are the hidden value of higher education. To engage ourselves to learn, make people learn, motivate them, encourage them to achieve some great. You can find some potential innovation during this COVID time, even the second race of COVID, you can find one innovation cost effective oxygen concentrator for COVID-19. My second innovation file patent is artificial intelligence based automatic surveillance system to easy detect oxygen leakage at inventory stage. Even if artificial intelligence is useful to understand the patient conditioning, using patient conditionings, different stages of COVID are there, using, you know, facial activity, facial expressions, body language also, you can moderate the, you know, the supply of oxygen to the patient. Apart from these innovations, few potential innovation into medical sciences, that into newborn babies or premature delivers, intensive care units. You can find one granted patent into cost-effective thermal mattresses to avoid hypothermia for neonatal patients. Oromotor simulation, a small electromagnetic vibrator, develop the genes of newborn baby so baby can suck and swallow mother's breastfeeding. Remote-assisted, cost-effective jaundice treatment device. Sterilized laminar flow workstation for neonatal intensive care units. And with respect to COVID initiative, you can find potential innovation into disinfectant sanitizer tunnels and herbal, your sanitizers, cost-effective herbal sanitizer. It is termed as chlorosanitizer. Some cost-effective mechanical and electromechanical integrated ventilators, breathe box. Breathe box is a potential innovation. One, you know, box fitted carry type of your ventilator within 15 kg, carrying one oxygen cylinder of 5 kg, and with digital displays to understand patient conditionings, to understand peak pressure, pulse pressure, breathing input and outputs, inlet pressure and outlet pressures. So likewise, you can find my innovation into sustainability, technological integration, deep learning. Using deep learning, we filed more than 4 patents together. It's a part of your new disruptive technologies. So we developed one device that is called a compact device for easy detection of or early detection of newborn skin diseases. Of premature delivers skin diseases, leukemia. Milia, hepatitis, your ringworms, pink pimples. So technology is everywhere. Technology only nowadays saving lives, and we are always fortunate being part of engineering society. If you talk about moderation of engineering, the essence of engineering coming through technologies, say it's artificial intelligence, machine learning, only learning is not sufficient. Practicing is not sufficient. Implementing the same into real-time innovation or product development, that will be helpful for our society, that's supposed to be our main motto. Rather, I always insist my students to learn about it. We established one 3D printing lab, one robotics lab, through different clubs. We are motivating students to learn, to practice, and to implement the things. Develop project. Project is the, you know, heart of engineering. Internship programs, projects, workshops, seminar, conferences, international conferences, writing, you know, index research papers, publishing research works, filing patent, taking benefits of intellectual property rights. At least we can avail the facilities of India and Australia. Those are nearby and easy accessible. Under intellectual property right, government of India, if suppose you are carrying one potential innovation or research work, you can take its Indian research copyright. It's very cost effective and easy processable. I'll take 2 minutes time to start the webinar. You can avail the facility of utility patent. Indian industrial design patents are there. I'll let you know how to file the patents, what sorts of, you know, procedures and drafting procedures and monetary engagement, government registration fees, everything I will explore you. You can go for a trademarks, or you can go for a, you know, geographical indications under intellectual property right, Government of India. If you talk about Australian government IPs, you can go for one innovation patent or any kind of standard patent. Innovation patent hardly taking 3 months time. It's a one of the most easiest and fastest procedures here in the world, next to South African patents. So if you talk about the world of research, I always divide into three parts, into three steps. First step, we must motivate or energize our young mass to launch chapters or book publication. Next to it, motivate them to write some, you know, index journal papers, qualitative index journal papers into Scopus, into, you know, your Web of Science or SCI index journals. And the highest form of, you know, research is called innovation. That is coming under intellectual property right, and you can easily facilitate, means take the facilities of this patents and copyrights. During this time, come to next slide please. During this time, you can understand how you face the difficulties in terms of remote education, healthcare difficulties. Here you can find, I have written few points: remote communication, online delivery of product, robotics, healthcare development, digital entertainment, remote educations. These are the difficulties, these are the barriers we face during 1.5 years of COVID. On the same time, you see how, you know, magical it is. Student, faculties, innovator, incubators, startups, government initiatives, everybody put at their effort best to learn from. We are learning from difficulties. When difficulties will arise, innovation will come to play. You can find one student of Lovely Professional University, he developed one cost-effective ventilator at cost of 250 rupees. One guy from CTC Bhubaneswar, Central Tool Room Training Center Bhubaneswar, one of the MSME government of India, they developed one chlorosanitizers, cost-effective ventilators, isolation chambers. You can find one of my potential innovation into remote healthcare and monitoring system that is called 5G-based optimized robot with a handheld ECG machine effective for intensive care units. It's a technological integration of four different sorts of applications. Your 5G, number one, Internet of Things, number two, one handheld ECG machine with one digital display with 12 number of sensors to monitor the patient conditionings, and robotic assisted. One robot is fitted with one digital display, which will be helpful for doctors and hospitals to monitor and easy, you know, coordination between the patient and the robot. And if for communication, you may implement IoT. I will let you know, few nowadays we are working for 3-4 innovation. You can find few potential work into newspaper. Before 15 to 20 days back, we came with one innovation. That's a compact electro acupuncture device for COVID treatment. You must heard about Aditya Birla Group, right? Aditya Birla running one franchise. One, you know, they are nowadays doing campaigning through a policy. One guy from Aditya Birla company, he identified three points in our left hand, pressing points. If you press these three points, na, there will be easy circulation of blood to our heart. So with respect to this novel ideation, we developed one potential what is called a device. Now we are developing that prototype with Arni University, Himachal Pradesh. and Reva University, Bangalore. The device is holding one DC motor, small DC motor, three metallic cones together, one non-stretchable rubber pad, and some binders. So that when air will pump inside, right, it will press these three points together, and that will be helpful to decrease the anxiety during the COVID patient, means they can reduce their anxieties. I'm a guy of Bhubaneswar sitting at Odisha. Here, daily 70 people are dying. And out of 70 people, exactly 20 are dying due to COVID. And remaining are dying due to, you know, high blood pressure or fears in heart mind that yeah, I am suffering from COVID. It might make some problem to me. One innovation into sustainability approach. I'll let you know. I'll take 2 minutes time to come to next slide. One is IoT based solar assisted inexpensive ceramic filtration for rainwater harvesting system. As per UGC guidelines, as per AICT guidelines, the total power consumption of every educational institute, suppose 40%, 40% of total power consumptions of every educational institute supposed to maintain by solar energy. And rain harvesting system is must. So implementing both, what we exactly did, we kept water inside a tank, right? Then using gravity irrigation, we used to flow that water into a glass box. 10 meter by 5 meter, we prepared one glass box with a 10 centimeter thickness. We filled it with water. When sun rays we allowed sun rays to fall over that glass box. When it will create or produce 30 to 40 degrees centigrade, it will kill all the antibodies or bacteria. 10% it will kill all the bacteria. Next, we allow for the natural filtration using one thermostat type IoT integrated one valve system that will allow the water from the glass box to a ceramic bowl. By nature, ceramic holding sufficient number of porosity, it's a natural filtration method. Up to 99% you can filter the water. So it will be inexpensive and easy, cost effective, non-electric plug-in type innovations, you can say, and you can easy implement into your institute also. IoT-based solar-assisted compost machine. Now I'm running under examination for this innovation patent under IP India. It's a solar-assisted, portable, cost-effective compost machine using one solar panel, one battery, one inverter, one DC motor, one your storing device, one steel container, and you can easily and ready prepare the compost within 7 to 8 days. The second potential innovation into robotics, I already developed two robots. One is digital farming robot that is named as Robha. Using 21 different type of sensors to understand soil conditioning, soil atmospheric monitoring systems. You can easily understand minerals level of soil, humidity, temperature, automatic irrigation system. Automatic irrigation system, automatic spraying, easy visualization system using LoRaBit 3.1-bit device. We extended the range up to 15 kilometers. I'm a professor of Lingayat University with some IIT students. I'm expecting young wards, young generation supposed to invest in this direction. Then only theory of learning is good. Practical hands-on learning is good. But unless until you implement the theorems into practicals, real-time product development, because these are the industrial practices. These are the things that are coming under industrial practices. We make our student very best, perfect enough to stand against it. The kind of difficulties, the kind of, you know, job means rate of people are, you know, discarding in industries. They are not getting right opportunities, only lack of technological integration. Yes. These are the 4 years time exactly. We need to make our student very, very perfect. There is no difference between boys and girls. Now girls are more, and they are doing good. With respect to boys, they are working very, very efficiently. Everybody appreciating girls' effort in companies. Girls are the backbone of the society. They are the mothers, they are the sisters, they are the, you know, they are the producers. Unless until we are encouraging our women society, motherly society, nation never can develop itself. And if you see all the, you know, test results, entrance examination results, girls are always doing best. Joint entrance examinations, gate examination, you can find girls are putting much more efforts. They are much more sensitive than boys. One digital farming climatic reader type of, you know, what is that called, your IoT based solar assisted climate reader digital farming robot. Climate reader will divide into two parts. One is macro level, one is micro level. Your intensity of sun rays, wind direction, and speed of the winds, these are the coming under in macro level. Soil conditionings, granular size of your soil so that you can easily decide what kind of cultivation is exact meant for. And separate is your minerals level. Likewise, you can select number of sensors together and integrate with Android. And using one solar panel, one battery, you can implement IoT as a communicating device. And for every kind of innovation, collaboration is must. Because irrespective of discipline, irrespective of department, irrespective of expertise area, because without management, you can't bring the product into market. Without a electronics engineer, you can't go for any technological sensor integrations. Without one mechanical engineer, you can't develop the infrastructures for any kind of innovations, because it's hardware type all the times. So it's a, what is that called? It's a multidisciplinary approach always innovations. Come to next, please. Next. Yes, here you can find few of our potential innovations. Sustainable solar assisted all natural clay cool refrigeration system. It's a mitti cool refrigeration. We developed, I'll showcase you, it's very interesting. One guy from, you know, Gujarat, Mansukh Bhai Prajapati. Early he developed one mitti cool, means one freeze made up of clay, riverside frost clay. Later we developed and tried to bring some sustainability approach. We fitted one solar panel, we fitted one DC motor, one battery, one pump, and modified into different layered chambers. I will showcase you how beautiful it is. For this innovation, we granted one Indian research copyright and one Indian industrial design patent. Next one is IoT-based sustainable manufacturing of organic fertilizers. We develop the ideations by taking, unequal percentage of ingredients like your cow dung and urine, your waste water coming from your house, green leaves together, we blended it, and a ready manufacturing of organic slurry, fertilizer slurry,
within 7 to 8 days. Air or water, it's a humidity dependent, I can't say it's a temperature dependent, it's a humidity dependent water extra, drinkable water extraction methods. Please come to slide. As I already told you, 5G based optimized robot, it's a, helpful for the long distance health monitoring systems, integrating four different type of sensors together. Wind powered IoT based sustainable organic compost machine, robotic process automated center shift mechanical ventilators, formulation and preparation of alcohol free herbal sanitizers, e-vidyalaya is a portal, empowering student and faculties together for online learning based. You can share your lecture notes, you can share your video links, and you can share, take the attendance online ERP systems. Smart carbonless cooking gasifier to avoid bronchitis, to produce clean and green gases. Adopting and researching innovative treatment technologies for hospital wastewater and detecting COVID infections. So likewise, we developed more than 145 number of innovations. For this, we have filed for the Indian patent, Australian patent. We taken Indian research copyrights together. Today, I'll take, now it's 17:42. Within 10 to 15 minutes, I will showcase you one case studies, one innovation, one, two innovations, how exactly we are thinking of innovation approaches and how we are filing for the patents. That will be very interesting. Come to next slide. The project title is, we already developed this innovation, I'll showcase you. The project title is Indigenous Thermal Matrices to Prevent Neonatal Hypothermia. This is the product we developed under guidance of Dr. Santosh, KIMS Medical College, Bhubaneswar. We developed four more innovations there. Out of that, one innovation it is. We granted patents for this same. Problem statement is, see, before going to any kind of innovation, you take a piece of paper like this, fold into two parts, right? Fold it into two parts. Left side, you write down all the societal problem statements. What are the problem statement? Left side. What are the societal challenges and barriers? Until, unless you'll go for, deeper into research studies, literature reviews, right? You can't file one quality patent. So before that, suppose your mind, you want to bring one, one perfume like this, perfume glass box is like this, for example, right? So before designing this, first of all, you have to see what are the glass box designs are available and how my design will be different and, aesthetic wise, or it will look beautiful and charming one. Like this way, when you are going for any kind of innovation, first of all, your home task is to read the problem statements, number one, define the societal barriers and difficulties. Then you download some quality index resource paper. Within 5 years back publication, suppose it we are running in 2021, you download paper from 2016 to 2021. Definitely somewhere, somebody in the world, definitely they forecasted or published some work related to that. Exactly not related to that. So the problem statement is, for this innovation, more than 21% of newborn baby or premature delivers here in India dying due to hypothermia. It's a fact. It's a true fact. Because we guys are sitting at, metro cities, we are sitting developed township area, we are not aware about what exactly happening in urban and semi-urban areas. You come to underdeveloped area like KBK, Koraput, Kalahandi, Balangir here in Odisha, you can understand. The interior area, people staying inside jungles, there is no health education, no hospitals, no schools are available. they are not, you know, they are not aware about how to care the babies even. And out of 21% of newborn babies, 70% babies are dying during the transportation, when the baby after birth, no, when you are taking the baby from hospital to house. Exactly. That during that time, you know, death ratio is 70% of 21%. Difficulty is the kind of facility available. ICU, because now every mother is a, you know, contradictory statement definitely. 99% mother nowadays, they are expecting cesareans. They want painless delivery. They don't want to take pain. Hardly 1% were expecting, you know, normal delivery. It's the fact actually. Caesarean means what? Premature delivers. Premature deliver means what? At least 10 to 15 days ICU facilities. You need a warmer, you need a ventilator at least for 10 to 15 days. For feeding and other things are separate, at least to warm up the baby with respect to, you know, right temperatures, ICU is required. And what is the expenses of ICUs? Minimum 10 to 15,000. I think everybody is aware about this, that ICUs facilities are very expensive and not easy available at every place. And if you are keeping the baby in ICUs, what is the minimum cost engagement for 10 days to 15 days? 2 lakh rupees. That's where going for insurance. Is it possible for one common man who is earning 25 to 30,000 rupees every month can invest up to 2 lakh rupees or 1 lakh? At least nowadays it's minimum investment of 1 lakh rupees during, you know, delivery time. Minimum 1 lakh rupees if you are going for any good hospitals. When baby inside mother homes, the exact body temperature supposed to maintain 36.5 degrees centigrade to 37.5 degrees centigrade. And the core temperature supposed to maintain 28 degrees centigrade. Right? But when baby coming outside, our surrounding temperature fluctuating all the times. Sometimes it is, you know, 15 degrees, sometimes 50s. So baby not able to cope up with atmospheric conditions. That leads to hypothermia. Even if there is a change, means our temperature reduction for 3 to 4 degree temperature, means it's a mild hypothermia. And what the consequence, if baby suffering from hypothermia, baby may go for coma or side paralysis. And the ordinary practice, whatever we are following during the transportation, we are warping the baby using a combal or using a towel or using a turkeys or using a bed sheet, which can sustain maximum temperature up to 18 degrees centigrade to 20 degrees centigrade, which is not much sufficient. Right? So with respect to this problem statement, come to next slide, please. We developed one indigenous innovation, cost-effective innovations. Here you can see, I've taken this photograph from KIMS Medical College. Left one is your open heart system. Product cost is 2.5 lakh. Right side is your warmer. Closed heart systems with one digital display. Cost of this product is 6.5 lakh rupees. And daily expenses is 10 to 15 inside this warmer. Come to next slide. Yes. Indigenous thermal matrices, you can see here. Come to back. One slide back, please. One slide back. Yes. Here you can find, we consider or we taken 0.5 gauge copper wires with some insulating coverings, two layers of thermal matrices, one automatic temperature control sensor, one 3D printing caskets with two different mode of operations, ranging temperature between 34 to 36.5 and 36.5 to 37.5 degree. Come to next slide, please. Here you can find the product at cost of 700 rupees. It satisfies or fulfilling the same requirement maintained by your open hearth system and closed hearth system. You know what expense and machinery as they are doing, same solution or you know output this product also giving at 700 rupees. It is fitted with you know four set of rechargeable batteries. So during transportation, you can easily you know keep your baby inside this warm mode and you can travel. It's the ancient practice. It's the you know formal transformation of knowledge or technology from ancient practice. Those mothers and sisters and you know, already you know get what to children. They must know about it. We used to keep the after delivery of baby. We used to keep the baby near you know some warmer. Or putting fire inside a bowl and we are keeping the baby nearby and we are massaging. We give massage. That real practice is called Entuti Sala here at Odisha. We are keeping the baby from day 1 to day 21 inside a corner of house near a fire station to warm up the baby. And after completion of 21 days, we are celebrating one function that is called Ekuisa. We are inviting all friends together, colleagues together, and we are celebrating that. But nowadays, doctors are, you know, advising even keep the AC in 29 or 30 degree and leave the baby. Baby is safe, but actually it's not. Medicinal practice is something different. We are not following that. That's why the death ratio is 21% nowadays. And we are not that much aware about this percentage. I think people must talk about it. That exactly 21% newborn babies are dying here in India. But yes, this is the research article survey by World Health Organizations. So for this innovation, we filed one Australian innovation patent. We granted it. And one Indian resource copyright. Come to next. I'll take you 5 minutes time to wind up the session because it's afternoon time, right? Cost effective water filtration using industrial fly ash waste. Now DST, METI, Technology Development Board, Government of India, through different MSMEs, 42 MSMEs are there. Then I will take 2 minutes time to understand the resource barriers and difficulties here in India. All are putting effort best how to promote innovations, how to promote innovators, students, educational institute for sustainability approaches, for reuse and recycle, water sanitations. These are the common needs, right? Implementation of, you know, different renewable sources of energies, easy cycle and management of, you know, industrial wastes. So keeping these things into view, we developed one potential work into cost-effective water filter catrice. If you go to market, you will purchase catrice. Right, it cost of minimum 2,000 rupees to 5,000 rupees. Charcoal activated, laser activated. Right, nanotechnology based something, some few activators are coming now in market. So this practice of manufacturing of cost effective batteries, cost engagement exactly 10 rupees. And what exactly we did? We have taken industrial fly ash from brick factory or an NTPC nearby, National Thermal Power Corporation. They are supplying fly ash free of cost. Nowadays, we are using fly ash for landfillings, for construction work. We collected the fly ash from nearby place. 60% by weight of your industrial fly ash, number one. Bentonite is a binding agent or binding element, you can say. 20% by weight and 20% by weight of water we mixed thoroughly inside a bowl. This is the real-time project practice for final year mechanical engineering students. Here you can find our professors are guiding students. We mixed thoroughly inside a bowl and put it inside a mold cavity to give it a proper shape. Hammered it to bring the compactness. Then we take away the things from the mold and kept inside a furnace. And the third figure here you can find. We kept for 30 minutes, ranging temperature between 600 degrees centigrade to 650 degrees centigrade. And right side you can find I'm holding a cartridge, water filter cartridge at cost of 10 rupees. First kind of innovation we are expecting from young mass. They can understand the problem statement. Likewise, they must take guidance of professor, teachers, mentors, because our teachers are always, you know, worthy, knowledgeous. They must know better than us.
Loudly, please, sir. I can hear your sound.
My voice is audible, ma'am?
Yes, sir. You are audible, sir.
Okay, fine. Yes, so for this innovation, we filed one patent and granted it one Indian research copyright. If you talk about patents and copyrights, patent to bring the scientific validations through experimentation, lab validations, experimental analysis, examination, that is called patent. Copyright means taking the proprietorship or taking the ownership of the innovations. You can find I already granted or extracted more than 25 number of, you know, copyrights from Register of Copyright Office, Government of India. If you are coming with an innovation with proper inventive steps, with proper ideations, with validated idea, with corrected, you know, correct your demonstrated diagrams, you can take its copyright. If you talk about patents, drafting supposed to very perfect. Plagiarism supposed to less than 5%, number one. You need to define your title of invention, considering kind of technology integrated, number one. What sort of input and output you are expecting exactly. Like this way, you have to form your title of invention. Abstract, not more than 15 lines. Very particularly, you need to describe the working principle of the innovation with its expected outcomes in your abstract. Then come to introduction. Generally, what practice we are following when I'm writing any research paper or review paper, what exactly we are doing? We are giving narration and we are narrating other things. Or giving showcasing what exactly happened in 1919, then what is 1995, then what is like reviews. They are bringing together in introduction or literature review. But in innovation, we have to forecast exactly all about our innovation, our work only. I need to sell my product, not others' product. So only and only we have to forecast about our work. Next to introduction, come to working principle. Very descriptively way, step by step, it will be more appreciable. Step by step, you write down the inventive steps, how exactly it is working. Then one illustrated diagram, one block diagram, simple block. See, innovation is supposed to be simple. And the drafting we are prepared, draft we are preparing, it's made for the examinations only. So the literature writing standard, the kind of, you know, words you are using supposed to be very, very perfect. We need to illustrate 1, 2, 3, like all the components together we integrated to develop this innovation. Next is claims. Very, very important thing is claim. When one examiner will read your, you know, literature or read your patent drafts, they will focus and put all the efforts to understand the claims of your innovations. Claims means what sort of component together, compatible components. Suppose you are using one 24 volt, you know, solar panel. So your battery and inverter supposed to be very supportive with respect to a specification of your solar panel. So it's supposed to be compatible, and with respect to specification, it's supposed to be very perfect. For example, I'm using one Arduino. This Arduino with this specification is the integral part of this innovation. Likewise, you have to state. Likewise, we need to develop minimum 5 to 10 numbers of claims we need to define for our innovations. Then social benefits, number one, because innovation made for society only. Societal benefits, number one. Number two, how come you start a business strategy? Incubation time frame analysis, number three. Number four, what the budgetary allocations, how much man, money, material, machinery, facilities, methodologies, requirement to develop this innovation. How come you reach your target audience? Right? So likewise, you have to develop minimum with respect to your qualitative work, you develop the content. But always remember, plagiarism supposed to less than 5% with the proper inventive steps. Nowadays people, what they're exactly doing, they're downloading some inventive papers from internet and doing kind of modifications. And few concepts are doing, means few students and inventors, they're thinking innovation means something new. For the first time it is coming to market, not exactly. You can bring some sustainable modification, number one. You can bring the qualitative aesthetics. It's supposed to look nice. That is called one innovation. Reducing the cost of the product. That is called also one innovation. If you are bringing any kind of suitable modification with respect to technological integration, that is also called one innovation. So likewise, you can come with your own approach, define it yourself, and two things always keep in mind before filing any patent or writing any research paper or qualitative index journals. What is the novelty and prior art of development of your work? Novelty means newness. Novelty means how come your product or your ideations or your theorems or your prototype different from others, and that you can achieve through Google patents, or you can search over IP India intellectual property right of Government of India website, or WIPO Switzerland's. WIPO is the indexing. When anyone will file patent or any kind of research work, qualitative research work, it will index at WIPO Switzerland. From that server also you can put out your keywords and you can search how many people already work for these innovations or Google patent. Like before going research review or literature review or writing any research paper, you are searching for Google Scholar. Likewise, Google patent is there, right? So ma'am, please share this PPT among all the audience, right? All the participants. Actually, it's already 6 o'clock. We can take some questions from audience. If you're holding any question, yes. Any question in your mind, you please unmute yourself and, open up your camera, right? I'm sharing my contact number and email ID here. And any much difficulties or, questions in your mind, you please mail me or you can direct call me 3404 9861113404. Here is my email ID. You please have it. Anything in your mind, right? Anything new ideation or a new product development or technological integration implementation, you please convey me. Here you can find my email ID and contact number. Or any question from audience, please.
I express my sincere gratitude.
Good evening, sir. Shall I ask, sir?
Yes, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
Sir, you can raise up your question. Yeah.
Yes, yes.
Sir, can you share any reference pattern? Already you have got pattern, so can you give any reference pattern drafts that can be
yes,
useful
yes,
for
yes,
us to
sure,
draft?
Sure, sure. I already connected with ma'am, the vice principal ma'am of this college.
Yes,
you can search over Ramesh Chandra Panda over parcel.ipaustralia.gov.in. You can find all my granted patents from there. You can download the certificate and documents from there. IP
sure,
parcel.
Sir. Sure, sir. We will contact the coordinator, ma'am. Sir. Thank you, sir.
Sure, sir. Any more, please?
Dear participants, it's time for you to raise the queries, or you may also use chat box to clarify your questions.
Use number of participants more than 230.
Sir, one more question, sir. You said
yes.
About WIPO. WIPO is the only website by which we can
for Indian patents.
Not specific innovation, sir.
Yes, yes. For Indian patent, I generally they used to index at WIPO Switzerland. From the search engine also you can find the things. WIPO Switzerland.
WIPO Switzerland.
Yes. WIPO.
Yes, sir. WIPO.
Switzerland. You can Google it. You can find its means login link also. You can click on that link and search engine will be there. There you can type anything and similar indexing type of research patent or research work will reflect on website. Suppose you are working with some cooking system, IoT based cooking. So you just write IoT cooking system. So related to that, whatever already invention are there, it will reflect on website with list of inventor, applicants and abstract. Everything you can find from there. These are the search engines like your Google patent, WIPO Switzerland's, IP India website also, patent search engines. There also you can find the details.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you for the input, sir.
Dear participants, if you have any other questions, just you can clarify. I express my sincere gratitude to Professor Ramesh Chandra Panda for making this session so interesting and informative. Sir, you have explained different innovation projects and also case study people have done during this COVID-19 pandemic. And you do have enlightened us by a vast knowledge on research and IPR practices. Once again, thank you for your valuable contribution. Now, I invite Engineer A. Joseph Selvakumar, Associate Professor of IT, to propose a word of thanks to our today's resource person and all the participants.
Good evening to all, virtually present here. First and foremost, I thank our Almighty God for His grace. On behalf of the IQAC of IDEA Engineering College for Women, it's my great privilege to propose the oath of thanks on this webinar. At the onset, I express my profound gratitude to our secretary, Reverend Mother John Brito Mary, for her encouragement, kind supervision, and provision for this webinar in her absence. I express my deep sense of commitment towards our resource person, Professor Ramesh Chandra Panda, Dean, Research and Development Cell, Synergy Institute of Engineering and Technology, Odisha, for being with us and orienting us in research initiatives and IPR practices with examples really needed to this current situation. By taking his time out amidst in his busy schedule. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Professor, for your previous information. I thank this opportunity. Take this opportunity to thank our principal, Dr. R. Gurumani, for his felicitations, continuous support, and encouragement. I express thanks to our vice principal and the IQAC coordinator, Dr. Sister Jenita, in organizing the webinar, and also thank the IQAC team members, coordinators, and moderators of this webinar. I express my whole gratitude to all the HODs, staff members, and the participants of our college and from various institutions for the virtual participation. Without you all, it won't be possible, and you all made it a successful event. To accompany us, let me once again echo my gratitude to all. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Dear participants, the feedback link is sent in the chat window. Complete the feedback form successfully. E-certificate will be issued to your register mail ID in a week. Thank you for your support and cooperation.